Hey everyone, welcome back again to our exciting series of cyber blogs presented by VIH Group. So today I'm going to give you pro tips for bug hunters. So this video is fully dedicated for the bug hunters, for the WAPT guys. So first of all, let's get understand what is bug hunting for the new babes. So basically, bug bounty hunters are ethical hackers who makes a hobby or even a business of finding security issue or bugs in an online businesses rather than misusing it. So most of the black hat hackers misuse it. Not most, almost all black hatters misuse it. And basically the bug hunters are the guy who just report bugs to the company from where the website belongs to. Maybe website or maybe server. So let's get started with our pro tips. So first tip will be clear your mindset about bug bounty. So first thing you have to make clear in your mind is like, give learning more prefer while earning. Okay, so at the initial phase or at a starting phase, just focus on learning, not on earning. Okay, so basically this is the point where the guy started lagging. They just focus on I have to earn money, and they just focus on money instead of just focusing on learning. So always, first of all, make focus on learning, not earning. Okay, so if you learn a lot, then for sure after few days, maybe after few months, you'll start earning. Okay, so this is the basic sequence. So let's get to our second point, a second power tip, which is always focus the target as it's a fresh one. So whenever a newly target comes to a platform, maybe on a bug crowd, maybe on HackerOne, just try to just get to that newly website, because there are chances of getting bugs are more than comparison to old website which are already present on bug reporting platform. So newly thing, you will get more bugs on the newly platform. So let's move on our third point, which is always look at path less visited, hunt on subdomain rather than main domain. So basically here's the point, is like most of the guys hunt on main website. Okay, and you all know main website is the main profile of the company where most of the visitor just visit there. Okay, so basically as the most of the visitor visit there, so companies will try to just enhance the security of the main domain. Okay, so basically there is the point, you should hunt on subdomain, because on the subdomain people not get engaged much and you will get more chances to find bugs. As you found in day-to-day life, most of the bugs found on Google or Microsoft, they are mostly on subdomain. Okay, so there are less chance of getting bugs on main domain. Bugs exist on main domain as well, but if you compare it to subdomain, there will be chances of getting more bugs on subdomains. So instead of focusing on main domain, you should focus on subdomain. Let's get to our another power point, which is don't rely only on online courses and videos. Reading books and blogs give much better insight. So basically at the starting phase or at the intermediate phase, most of the bug hunters go to the learning from courses, from video courses. This is good thing, while learning from video courses, this is good thing, but you should also just read articles, you should read books, because in books there's a lot of thing covered which will be not get in the courses, because the instructor should have to create a small course, okay, and which contain a lot of information. But if you compare it to the book contain a much information as comparison to video courses. And yeah, if you read write-ups, like some bug hunters write their own write-ups, so you'll get the insight like how they find bugs and all the things. So in the straightforward manner, you should go for reading as much as you can instead of comparing to course and videos. So you will learn a lot on reading. Okay, so let's get to our next point, which is don't ask people to share their POC videos. Basically, this is a creepy thing. Okay, I know you guys are thinking like, this is stupid. He is just telling me, don't ask for the POC. And here, as you see on my display, it's written, don't ask people to share their POCs video if they want to flaunt would be share it before. So basically the point is if someone wishes to give you the POC, they already give, they for sure give you. Okay, so if you gonna to ask them, please share me the video, there are some kind of secret tips. Okay, in some instance there are some secret tips. So most of the bug hunters are not gonna to just give you their own POC. Okay, and this is why you should don't ask for the POC. Okay, and instead of asking, you can Google out. You will get a lot of article, you will get a lot of blogs, even you will get a lot of videos. Okay, from where you can take out your POC and start hunting more website. So this is a legit point when most of the bug hunters get, and yeah, they also get demotivated when someone will not give you some sort of POCs. So this is a point where people start lagging. So according to me, you should not ask for the POC. If you need any kind of POC, you can just drop your mail on support@vihgroup.com. We can for sure share you, and we can just refer you to some of the blogs and article which may help you. So this is point where we can also help you, and you should not ask POC to some of the professionals or maybe some of the bug hunters who is doing some high thing. Okay, if they wishes to share, then for sure they will upload it on their Twitch or maybe on their YouTube. Okay, so yeah, now let's get to our another power tip, which is follow everyone from InfoSec. So on mostly on Twitter, hands-on people let us blog as soon they are available. So basically you should follow most of the bug hunters on their social media, like Twitter, on the Instagram, because they all time they start some sort of live session, they post a lot of things on their Twitter. Maybe it may be some kind of articles, maybe some kind of write-ups. So you should go for Twitter, where you'll get a lot of new things. Okay, new, if they'll find some new bugs, okay, they will post on Twitter. And yeah, you will get on LinkedIn as well, but there are chances of getting more responses will be on Twitter. One of my friend from outside of India, which is Strock Frederick, so yeah, so he post a lot of information on Twitter. Okay, so you should follow Strock Frederick as well, and there's a lot of professionals like Nahamsek and all. So you should go through Twitter so that you can get insight that what they do, what from where they learn, and all the things. And next point from my side will be, don't feel you are starting late. It's never late to do anything. So if you think like you are in the age of 24, 25, 26, so, and you are starting at the age of 25, so don't think yourself as you are starting late. So and there's a lot of example, like most of the bug hunters start from the age of 28, 29, even 30, 35, and they are doing awesome in their career. So don't feel yourself that you are starting from late. But there's a main point, like whenever you start, if you don't start, then there is nothing point from my side. And if you will start hunting, and if you start learning bug hunting, then from that part you have to try hard. Okay, because after starting, if you lag, then it will just, you have to pay a lot. Okay, so basically if you start, then you have to complete it at the last. Okay, so yeah, and you will also enjoy a lot while reading and doing all the stuff relatable. Next point will be, pick one program you like and stay attached to it as long as possible, more chances to find. So basically here's the point from my side is, whenever you will get some sort of program on any of the reporting platform like Bugcrowd, HackerOne, so you should pick a single program at first. Like if you gonna to just check out any of the website, you should take it and you should analyze it as well. If it will take a lot of time, then you for sure you have to go through it. And basically the point is, like if you research a lot on a single website, okay, if you will not get any kind of bug in 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, but after few day you will get some good bugs, because at the starting phase most of the bug hunters report some basic bugs, and after sometime there's a critical bugs which may be not find by some of the infosec guy. So if you try hard and if you just invest your lot of time on that particular program, you are gonna to get some precious bug and which can pay you a lot. Okay, so there are more chances to find bugs. So just catch up with some program and start hunting. And this is thing where all the guys lag. Okay, so basically the thing is don't cry over duplicates. So basically, as per I know, duplicates means whenever you are reporting some sort of bug on any other particular website, duplicate means someone already reported the same before you're reporting. So don't feel sad like this small girl. So basically you'll after some time you'll get some sort of bounty, but duplicates doesn't mean like you should demotivate yourself. So basically you found a bug, but the thing is like you reported it lately, so whenever you'll get bug, just report at the same time. Okay, and this is the one of the main point that I would like to discuss with you guys. I would like to mention is like, understand the impact of every bug. What does this bug do? How does a hacker use it? So basically when you are gonna to report some sort of bug, and whenever you are gonna to learn any kind of bug like XSS, maybe SQL, cross-site request forgery, any kind of bug, so you should know like what does this bug do, instead of like some of the infosec, some of the beginners just inject the payload like script underscore alert one and script close. So basically this is the parameter which you use in XSS. This is a starting thing. Okay, so just read it out like what this kind of bug do, how it can impact the website. Okay, so and how a hacker can use it, like if you are reporting and you will get stopped at that instance like you got the bug, but you should also learn like how does a hacker use it. Okay, how the hacker gonna use it, how the hacker gonna just exploit and get the access of the website. You don't have to do exploit, but you should learn on your local host as well, some of the website as well. And yeah, we are also creating some sort of labs which will be free for each and every guy, so it will be a gift from our side for all the our subscribers. Okay, so you can practice there as well, it will be free for you guys. Okay, and yeah, at last, take money because you are awesome. So whenever you report some sort of bugs, so just take money and you feel inspired yourselves because you are awesome and you try hard, and after it you are also gonna to try harder. So this is all about pro tips that I wishes to share with you guys. So if I am lagging and if I done any kind of mistake, then please tell me and just comment in the comment box. Okay, so yeah, and guys, please do comment in the comment box because it inspires me a lot while creating new and more videos. So thank you very much, and you can follow us on any of the platform by using @VIH group. It may be Instagram, it may be YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, anything. And if you get any kind of query, then you can also do mail on support@vihgroup.com. So I think you like this video. So if you like this video, you can do click the like button, and I'm not gonna to force you for the subscribing because it's all on you. And you guys are awesome. Think secure. Think VIH.